What is up, you guys? Today I'm gonna be sharing with you my software engineering desk setup and all the different tools I use to write code on a daily basis. Currently, I'm working remotely on some startups, so I spend a lot of time in this setup building those projects. What I'm gonna be sharing with you today is a result of several years working on my setup and figuring out what I enjoyed the most for my workspace and how I could be more productive. There are some things I still want to improve, but I'm really excited to share with you guys all the stuff I'm using, and I'm hoping this video will help you figure out your workspace too. Out of everything in my setup, my favorite part is my desk, and it's what I'm most proud of. I had been wanting a standing desk for a while, but because I live in Puerto Rico, it's kind of hard to find a good, large, quality standing desk that would be affordable and I could find in a store or would ship here, because a lot of the larger items you find online often don't ship to the island. When I was doing some research, I found out that I could order a pair of standing electric desk legs on Amazon, and those would actually ship to my house and were a more affordable option. I found a pair of legs made by a brand called Topski on Amazon, which had really good ratings and were in my price range, so I ordered those online. After that, I had to figure out what I was gonna do for the top of my desk. You can find some relatively cheap large desk tabletops in somewhere like IKEA, but I didn't find a good option in Puerto Rico, and I enjoy doing some woodwork, so I decided to build my own. I did some research and watched some YouTube videos, and then I went over to Home Depot and I got some pine wood that I brought back home, and then I glued together with wood glue, pocket holes, and a clamp. And then I cut the top to size. It ended up being 69 by 32 inches and 1.5 inches thick. It's kind of an arbitrary size, but the desk legs I ordered on Amazon would support it. It was large enough for my needs, and it would fit in my room. After I cut it to size, I applied some dark walnut wood stain, which I think looks really nice, and then I applied several coats of clear gloss polyurethane to protect it. Once I got the legs, I put the top and the legs together, and there you have it. I have my very own custom standing desk. These standing legs have worked out great. I don't use them as much because I still sit way too often throughout my day, but I really like having the option, and I'm trying to push myself to stand more and be more active. Moving on to my chair, I have a pretty basic leather chair that I found in Office Max and thought was relatively comfortable, but I do think that I need to make an upgrade at some point in the future and get something a little more ergonomic. All right, let's move on to what powers my setup. The computer I use is a 2020 Intel-based 13-inch MacBook Pro with 16 gigabytes of RAM and 256 gigabytes of storage. I've actually used Windows my whole life, and throughout my 4 years of college, I had a Windows Surface Book that served me really well. But when I interned with Zillow in Seattle, I enjoyed the experience of developing on a MacBook. And at the time I got this computer, I was actually transitioning from writing all of my code and doing all of my work in the VS Code text editor to a completely terminal-based workflow with Tmux and Vim. And while a MacBook provides a better experience for that, as it is a Unix-based environment, I could have gone with Linux, and I might still do that in the future, but I enjoy the macOS user experience and having the option of doing iOS development if I ever need to in the future. I got this computer before the M1 MacBooks had come out, and I'm actually really interested in the 14-inch M1 Pro MacBook that came out at the end of last year. I think it would be really good for my video editing in Final Cut Pro, and I really like that they added back a bunch of the ports that my MacBook is missing, but I'm still saving up for that. Talking about ports, because my MacBook has only two USB-C ports, I have a portable hyperdrive USB-C hub that I use to connect my monitors, charge my computer, and connect my keyboard and my mouse, all of which I will cover in this video. Moving on, the monitors I have are essential to my workflow, and I really enjoy having a lot of screen real estate. When you're working on complex projects, you often have a lot of stuff open, like your code, maybe some tests, a bunch of browser tabs with Stack Overflow, Google searches, documentation, maybe another window for listening to music, and probably something like Slack for talking to your team. As a result, my monitors help me have all of that stuff out in front of me. For my primary monitor, I have a Samsung 34-inch ultra-wide monitor. It's worked out really great for me. This is where I usually put my code. I usually split it into three vertical columns inside Vim, so that I can see three files of code at once. I also do a lot of video editing in this monitor. I really like that I can see a lot of the timeline when I'm working on my videos in Final Cut Pro. My secondary monitor is a 32-inch Lenovo monitor. I usually use this monitor to put my apps and visualize them, especially when I'm doing front-end work. And I also use this monitor for browsing the web and looking things up whenever I have questions or I get stuck, which happens very often. And finally, I keep my MacBook open. This is usually where I have my miscellaneous stuff, like my Spotify or having Slack or Skype open to talk to the teams I'm a part of. To hold my monitors up, I have a Wally dual monitor arm I ordered from Amazon, which had really good reviews, and it's honestly been one of the best purchases I've made for my setup. It's really sturdy, it's supposed to hold up two 32-inch monitors, but it holds up my ultra-wide and my other 32-inch monitor just fine. It comes in really handy for changing the orientation of the monitor screens and also raising them up to clear up some space in my desk and putting my MacBook below the ultra-wide. Curiously, because my desk setup is in my bedroom, my 32-inch monitor also acts as my TV. Because it has only one HDMI input, I have an HDMI switch to connect both my MacBook and a Google TV to the monitor. Whenever I want to watch TV, I raise my desk up because I have a raised bed. I change the orientation of the monitor to face my bed. I click on the HDMI switch to change the input to the Google TV. I connect the Google TV to my speakers via Bluetooth because the monitor doesn't have audio out, and voila, now I can watch TV from my bed with a remote. All right, let's move on to my pride and joy, my keyboard. It's an Iris Rev 4 split mechanical keyboard. I switched to mechanical keyboards a while ago and I'm never going back. I used to have a regular gaming mechanical keyboard, but I wanted something a little more ergonomic, so I decided to try out a split keyboard. There aren't a lot of pre-built options, except something like an Ergodox Easy, so I decided to build my first custom mechanical keyboard. I found a kit for my keyboard that had most of the parts that I needed on a website called keyb.io, and then I got a soldering kit from Amazon, a set of blue LEDs to install inside my switches, which are clear MX Brown switches, and a keycap set from drop.com that I actually ordered on Amazon. Apart from my keyboard for my mouse, I have a Logitech basic and cheap mouse. It works fine, but I eventually want to get an MX Master 3, which is a lot better, but I'm also saving up for that. I also use this Magic Trackpad with my MacBook. I really enjoy having the trackpad to do all the different gestures that are available to you when you're using a trackpad, and that pairs up nicely with also having the regular mouse. When it comes to my speakers, I had debated for a while what I wanted to do. I had seen a bunch of videos on YouTube of people with the Kanto YU2 or Audio Engine white portable speakers that look really nice, but I wanted to do something a little different. I went with a pair of Klipsch bookshelf speakers that I thought looked really nice and would pair well with my setup. They also had really good reviews. Because these speakers don't have a built-in amplifier, I got a mini Bluetooth amplifier that wouldn't occupy much space and had really good ratings on Amazon. The mini amplifier has worked out great. I really like that it has Bluetooth functionality so that I can connect my devices and my Google TV easily to the speakers. And I usually connect my MacBook to the amplifier via an aux cable. Because of my monitors, the speakers wouldn't fit in my desk, so I went ahead and used a scrap piece of wood from when I built the desk to build a shelf above my desk to put the speakers in. They're actually pretty high up above my desk whenever I'm sitting. This is because I have a standing desk and I didn't want to block the desk whenever I was raising it up. It isn't the most optimal position for when I'm sitting and listening to music, but it works out fine for my needs. Whenever I get tired of my speakers and I want to focus a bit more, I use my headphones instead. I also use them for video editing. These are a pair of Sony WH-1000XM3s, kind of a crazy name, but I bought these when I was an intern. I think they're really nice. I really love the noise canceling and I think they sound great. I have a mini kickstand thing that clamps to my desk that I use to hang them. All right guys, to finish things off with some miscellaneous items, I also have a Rubik's Cube on my desk. I usually use this to fidget when I'm thinking through a coding problem. I used to know how to solve it, but I don't remember that much, so I really don't know how to solve it anymore. I also have some fake plants on my desk from IKEA that I use for decoration. I also have a real plant. This is my first real plant. I got it recently. It's a pothos. It's supposed to be hard to kill, so I hope it doesn't die on me. I also have a water bottle. I use this to keep hydrated, pretty important. And I also have a hard drive for storing my photos and videos, and a SanDisk SSD drive to also store my videos, but I usually have the videos I'm currently editing and working on for YouTube on this drive. And that's it. Those are all of the different tools and gadgets I use as a software developer as a part of my desk setup. Thanks so much for watching, you guys. I hope you enjoyed the video and found it useful. This setup has taken me several years and has been a lot of work, but it's also been really fun and I'm really proud of it. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, leave a comment down below so that I can answer any of your questions, and leave a like, which really helps me out. See you guys in the next one. Peace.